In this video, I'll go more into detail about Zoom, and the first thing I'm gonna do is show you how to join a meeting. So there are two ways you could join a meeting. You could join a meeting through the Zoom app, which is currently what I'm on, or you could join a meeting through email, which I'll show you later. So first, to join a meeting through the app, we're gonna select join. From here, you're gonna write the meeting ID that needs to be provided to you. You're gonna write your first and last name. Then you can select if you want audio connected or if you want your video on or off. Once you select join, then it's gonna ask you for the meeting password. This also needs to be provided to you. And then from there, it'll allow you to join the meeting. Now for the second type of way you can join a meeting is the email way.
The second way that you could join a Zoom meeting is if someone has sent you a Zoom link and you've accepted it, then it will appear on your Outlook calendar. For example, this is the Outlook calendar, and here, this is a Zoom link to a Zoom meeting. We're gonna select the link, and from here, it should take you directly to the Zoom meeting. And as you can see, we're in the Zoom meeting. So now I'll be showing you how to schedule a Zoom meeting so you can send it out to your peers in case you guys are studying. So you need to be on the Zoom app, and from here we're gonna select schedule. Then you have the option of renaming your Zoom meeting. So in this case, we're just gonna name it Zoom meeting. And then you can select the day you want it to start, the time you want it to start, the time you want it to end, and perhaps the day you want it to end. Or you can select reoccurring meeting, meaning that you guys are gonna meet every Monday at 1 o'clock. And then you have more settings on meeting ID, on the security, the video, the audio, and the calendar. Once you've gone through all the settings, we're gonna select save. Now this is gonna appear, it's gonna want you to save and close to your Outlook calendar so it can remind you 15 minutes before the Zoom meeting. So we're gonna save and close. So now as you guys can see here, the Zoom meeting has been saved on the Zoom app. So now in order to send the Zoom invitation to your peers, we're gonna select the three dots. We're gonna select copy invitation, and then we're gonna go to Outlook. We're gonna create a new email. Then from here, we're gonna select paste, and the Zoom invitation will be ready to go to send it to your peers. Here it will tell them who invited them to the Zoom meeting, and it will give them the Zoom link so they can automatically join your meeting at the appropriate time. Next to the participants, then we have the chat. You have various options in order to chat with people, so let's see your options. To see the options, we're gonna select the three little dots. Here you can save the chat, or you can chat with no one, with the host only, with everyone publicly, and with everyone publicly and directly. So I just have it with everyone. And as you can see here, I put hello twice already, and if I were in a real Zoom meeting, then everyone will be able to see that I put hello in the chat. Next to chat, then we have a share screen. I'm gonna show you how to share your screen in case you need to present PowerPoint or present in video. So we're gonna select share screen, and then you have three options. You have your desktop, your iPhone AirPlay, or your iPhone iPad via cable. So we're gonna select desktop, and then you're not gonna select the share computer sound, and you're not gonna select the optimized screen share for video clip. Once you've selected desktop, then we're gonna select share. This is how it looks to share your screen. Once you're done sharing your screen, then you're gonna go to the top in the red where it says stop share, and it'll go back to your regular Zoom meeting. Then we have end. This is where you'll be leaving your Zoom meeting. So you select leave meeting, and then you're done with Zoom. Now we'll be showing you some of the important things that you need to know while being in a Zoom meeting. The first one being where your mute and unmute button is at. Your mute and unmute button is located on the lower left side corner. And next to that, we have the start video button. This is where you have the option of turning on or off your camera for the meeting. Next to that, we have the participants button. This is where you can see everyone that's joined the meeting. Currently, it's just me, and then you can see who the host is. This is also where you'll be able to rename yourself. So to rename yourself, we're gonna select more, and then rename. Students need to put the first and last name for their Zoom meeting. Then we're gonna select rename, and everyone will be able to see your new name. Keep in mind, not all instructors allow this setting. Some instructors do not allow it because they already want your first and last name in order to join the Zoom meeting. Underneath that, we have the reaction button. This is where you can say yes or no to a question, and all the reactions will be next to your name, as you can see there. Then we have go slower and go faster. Other reactions are thumbs up, thumbs down, clapping, the coffee one, which means need a break, and the clock, which means you're away. And now to delete all of those, you're just gonna clear all, which is a little eraser. Now I'm gonna show you where to locate your settings and how to add a virtual background. So to locate your settings, you're gonna go to the upper left side corner, and you're gonna select the green check mark.
Then we're gonna select the setting icon, and this should take you directly to your settings. So here we have general settings, and these are all the ones you could choose from. You can also select which theme you'd like, so light or dark. And then we have reaction skin tones, so there's a variety to choose from. Then you have your video settings, your audio settings, your screen share, the chat settings, my favorite, the background settings. So we have a variety of virtual backgrounds that you can select from. You also have the option of adding your own image or video. And Zoom also has video filters. So you can add these on top of your virtual backgrounds. We also have recording settings, your profile settings, statistics, feedback, keyboard shortcuts, and accessibility settings.